please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Now joining in to talk technicals is Ashwani Gujral. Ashwani, it's been quite a week for the street. We've seen all-time highs on the index, but stocks, particularly mid-caps, are bleeding. Your reading?
Fairly clear that a narrow market has very limited upside. Now, yesterday and day before you had Reliance or TCS doing 5-6%. Today you didn't have that. So that way, given the way the momentum with which mid-caps are falling, I don't think you'll be able to cross 11,050, 11,070 with any sort of sustainability. So right now this zone is perfect to go short. Why? Because your stops are very close by. If you start taking out day before's high, then your trade is over. But if this continues and every day you have 1250 decliners to 350 advancers, finally the large caps will also start to come under pressure. And the market will sell off, and maybe first target could be 10,850, 900. So that way, it's not looking strong at all. While large cap indices are not still moving, but it's clear that the market is lacking strength or momentum to move higher.
Okay, so if the Nifty starts to break down, what levels are we looking at, Ashwani?
See, the breakout zone of 10,850, 900, and it shouldn't be surprising because, that sort of breakout needs clarity on election, which is the macro event. You've seen crude prices fall, inflation was better than expected. All that has not led to, financials moving higher, which means that those are not enough triggers at these levels to move up and, in fact, have been used by the market to engineer a sell-off.
Okay, Ashwani, now let's talk sectors. What are the weakest links in the market right now?
See, PSU banks are the weakest. Along with that, basically the entire mid-cap area is extremely weak. NBFCs are looking fairly weak because people were long NBFCs in expectation of them moving higher. So this entire, domestic area, which is their financials, NBFCs, all sorts of infrastructure. If you see the way, NCC, NBCC, all these stocks are crashing. Basically, it does not seem like there are a lot of buyers in any of those mid-cap type stocks. And that's where, the shorts are going to make a killing next week, because if large caps also start to fall, then mid-caps will really get bludgeoned.
Ashwani, just one last point on the market itself. Some of the indicators, be it oil, be it other global equity markets or yields, you put all those things together, they're not looking exactly bearish. Incrementally, there is a bit of improvement in all those things. How does that really fit in with your view that maybe the mid-caps and small-caps are going to prevail over large-caps? The Nifty is going to head lower.
See, these are the right answers at the wrong time. Had the Nifty been 10,500, all of these factors would have led to a large rally. But we got the rally before these factors, and at 11,050-70, I think people want to get off the bus, before the opinion polls and our music starts. So the kind of sell-off we've seen last couple of days is very strong profit booking, and people who've been holding through this turmoil, etc. Once you see the previous high back, they just want to dump it.
Okay, all right. In that case, what should be the trades for next week, Ashwani?
See, for Monday, particularly PSU banks have closed week. So Canara Bank is a sell with a stop of 236, target of 224. Engineers India is a sell with a stop of 125, target of 117. And Nagarjuna Construction is a sell with a stop of 92, target of 84.
All right, Ashwani, thank you very much for that. You have a good weekend, and we will see you again on Monday as well.